Hello everybody and welcome to the Realm of Myths. My name is Phaethodas and this guy here is the Dragonborn and Dragon Hunter build. This is the update video to this build, which means that right now I am in a place where I have finished the legendary campaign. I have defeated everything in the game except for the secret passage of Ragnarok. I haven't been to that place because I was searching for my key, the frog key, to go and open up the door to go in that place, but I cannot find my key. I think I lost the key. Anyway, I will have to recreate the key. But other than that, I have played everything. I have been everywhere in the game with this character. And I'm here now in this video to tell you about how this build did in legendary difficulty, the campaign, the overall campaign. Well, the build is very powerful. This is 100% a fact. It is very, very powerful. It is a lethal build. It destroys enemies very, very fast and very, very efficiently. It is very fast as a build, but of course it has some weaknesses. Let me activate all of the skills and we will see. This one, this one. Okay, we have all three skills active that we can have. Now, resistances. The resistances, as we can see, are what they were, even in the base build guide video, a little bit. Maybe they are a little bit different, because after I finished Legendary, I upgraded this item, the Helmet of Valhalla, and I got the Weightless prefix, which for this specific build is useless, because it gave me reduction to requirements, which this build doesn't need right now. So it is a total waste of a slot, of a prefix. And the suffix is of impetus. Impetus provides slow resistance. So, yeah, slow resistance is not bad. But anyway, we have 80% slow resistance now, with 60% from this one. Okay, 80% is perfect. But this is what I got from the legendary upgrade, actually, on this helmet. It was a waste of an upgrade, actually. I'd rather get something that would boost more my health or some of my resistances, or maybe something that would help with damage output. I don't know. Something like that. Now, weightless prefix, especially weightless prefix, is totally useless anyway. This is what I got from legendary upgrade, and this is the state of the build currently. We have minus 20 fire, minus 27, minus 40, 33, minus 40, maxed out, minus 21, 0. Combined armor is very good, except for the torso, because the torso is very... this one is, by the way, again upgraded. I upgraded this one when I started, if I remember correctly, playing Legendary campaign. This one is awesome because it provides plus 41% attacking speed. This is the main reason why I use this one. Because I wanted to have here something that would allow me to take my attack speed up to the maximum, which is 222% for bows. I have 221%. I mean, if I could replace somehow this one with something much better that would give many more resistances, at the lower attacking speed, it would be better, but I would lose this attacking speed. So, the idea behind this build was to get my attacking speed up to maximum if possible, and at the same time to increase my projectile speed as much as possible. This is the idea, and this is why I have all of these bad resistances here. Because the goal of the build is not to have good survivability, it is to have the best possible speeds at attacking speed and projectile speed. So, this is the build. How did this build fare against enemies in Legendary campaign? Well, it was very powerful, it did great, but throughout the whole Legendary difficulty I died 31 times. Yes, it says 34. I do not count the three deaths, the final deaths, because those deaths happened against Oxeus, and that was to be expected. I mean, Oxeus uses lots of damage reflection. This build is super duper powerful, and one arrow of mine, if it gets reflected back to me, it kills me. So, actually, I died because of damage reflection of Toxeus, which means I killed myself. And I also died about 10 times because of damage reflection of other enemies. You know, in the game we have Dragonian mages that deal damage reflection. We have some enemies in Ragnarok Act, in the last places of Ragnarok, that deal damage reflection. So, many times I wasn't careful enough and I killed myself because of my attacks that hit enemies with damage reflection. They reflected back to myself and they killed me. Other than that, you know, you have to be careful, especially when you have such bad resistances and survivability options. You have to be careful. If you are careful enough, you survive. If not, you die. So, the build is awesome, guys. This is what I'm going to tell you. It is a small update video for this build. If you are wondering how good this build can do in Legendary campaign, this build is awesome, very powerful, super duper satisfying to play with. So, if you got to play this build, try to get the items and play the build. It is absolutely amazing. And this is why it has become my top favorite build ever, or at least so far, in Titan Quest. Yeah, before this one, it was God Zeus, my top favorite, but anyway. Now it is this one. Who knows what the future will bring when it comes to builds. Maybe I will find something that I will like even more. Who knows? We will see. We will see. I don't know. Let's kill these frogs here. You don't know, maybe you will get some good items from the frogs. After all, the plan is to be making many builds in the future. We have... I'm going to make some more damage reflection builds. And other builds as well. I mean, other types of builds as well. So, yeah. This is it, guys. This build is awesome. It is the best. For me, personally. So, I will see you very soon with much more content, more videos, more... by the way, I have already some new builds coming up of Titan Quest, about 5 or 6 new builds. And we will have more builds, especially this month in December, the last month of 2020. And I will see you very soon with live streams and more videos. Have fun whatever you do, play Titan Quest, and kill Carcinos crabs in the beach of Rhodes.